Welcome to the Night Court.
She was Aelin Ash River Galathinius, and she would not...
Light it up, Danica!
I fired
out. You could rattle the stars. You could do anything. If you only once
upon a time, to the people who in a land long since burned to ash,
stay with
there lived a young princess who lost her kingdom.
I read all 16 Sarah J Maas books, and it is literally all I can think about. I have formed deep, deep connections with all these characters. I mean, ACOTAR, that is literally like my family. They taught me how to love and to live, and then I went out on my own and I met the people of Throne of Glass, and those are literally like my comrades, my brothers in arms, okay? We went to war together, we bled together. I would literally die for them. And Crescent City, they're like my distant cousins I see at Christmas, and you know, we put on a little dance to try and ask our parents to let us have a sleepover. You know what I mean? I mean, seriously, just the journey I went on with these characters is just insane. Okay, for example, here's me reading Kingdom of Ash.
I'm gonna sue Sarah J Maas for emotional abuse.
The point is, I clearly have too many pent-up feelings and thoughts about these characters and about these books. So today I'm going to be doing a tier list ranking of all of the SJM men. I can't do all of the characters in one video, that would be literally insane. So today I'm just gonna be ranking all of the male characters, you know, from my husband down to my mortal enemy sort of vibes. This will definitely include spoilers, but I'm gonna break it up into parts. So we're gonna start with ACOTAR, then Throne of Glass, then Crescent City. So you can just stop the video if you haven't made it to the next series yet. Say if you've only read ACOTAR, stop before you get to the Throne of Glass section. If you have only read ACOTAR and Throne of Glass, stop before you get to the Crescent City section. You picking up what I'm putting down? And please, for the love of God, do not watch this if you haven't read these books. You do not want this spoiled for you. Like this is gonna be really key information I'm going over here, and you do not want it spoiled for you, I promise. Like, reading these books for the first time and going through all these emotions for the first time is so fun. Do not spoil it for yourself. And also, if you haven't read these books yet, simply why? Simply what are you doing? It is life-changing, okay? We've all been there. I had the same reservations. On July 7th, 2023, my friend Faith texted me and asked if I had read A Court and Thorn of Roses. And I said, and I quote, "I'm just not a big fantasy person." Oh, how wrong I was. So just do yourself a favor. I say start with ACOTAR. It's the easiest to get into. Then move to Throne of Glass. Then move to the Crescent City. Okay? It will change your life. For better or for worse, I don't know, but it will change your life. So one last time, leave now if you have not read these books, but if you have, stick around and let's get to ranking. So here's our tier list. I did not make this tier list, but I will link it in the description down below. Now, for the pictures of the characters, I chose this one specifically because they have the names of the characters, and I just found that to be easier when sorting. But some of the fan art is not my favorite, okay? So just give them grace, okay? Some of them look a little off, but that's okay. We know in our hearts what they look like. So for the ACOTAR section, we are starting with Asriel. As is one of our three bat boys, as we know, I love him dearly. He's kind of the quiet one, the shadow singer, the spy. I am really, really excited to hopefully learn a lot more about Az in the next book, but as of right now, we don't know a ton about Az. So I'm just ready for him to be at the forefront, but he is definitely going in A tier for me. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And just to be clear, S is gonna be reserved for like my husband's. Like, we're married. Okay, next we have Baron, High Lord of the Autumn Court in ACOTAR. I don't like this dude. I don't like him one bit. He's an asshole. He's just mean. He's just mean, he's rude. I don't like him. So, F, he has no redeeming qualities. It's not like, yeah, I can't think of any redeeming qualities for him. Okay, next we have Jurian. Now Jurian, he's kind of a bit more complicated. I'd say we spend the majority of the series thinking he's like kind of an asshole. But then it's like revealed to us, you know, he was just a spy, you know, he's a bit of an anti-hero. He's on the other side, but he's working for us, but he's done some bad things, but and I wouldn't say like he's a very attractive character for me, just in the way he's described and his personality and stuff, but he's still like an ally of ours, I guess. I don't know, I'm thinking D or C, to be honest. I think I'm gonna go with D for now, but he could get moved up, seeing where things, you know, lie. Next we have Tamlin, also known as Tampon, Tam-Tam, Dick. In A Court of Thorns and Roses, we think he's an all right dude. No, he's the worst. He's F tier, so clearly. There has never been a more F tier. I know for some reason I've been seeing like a couple people on TikTok being like, I want to see a Tamlin redemption arc. I think he might be Elaine's mate. Why? Why would you want to see a Tamlin redemption arc? I don't understand. I don't think he deserves one. I don't think we need one. Like, I think he can just be off on his own. I think it'd be good for him to like, you know, become a better person, sure, but I don't care about him. Like, I don't think he should be in the narrative that much, to be honest. Like, I'm done with him. He's run his course. We're done. And he's not being redeemed for me. I don't care what happens. Next, we have Rhys and my High Lord. High Lord of the Night Court. I love this man so much. Rhys to me is perfect, okay? And I know for some reason, people are starting to turn on Rhys, okay? There's kind of an anti-Rhys campaign going on right now, and I'm not for it, okay? You will never change my mind. I don't care. I'm a Rhys stan. I think he is perfect. I absolutely adore his love story with Feyre. Like, Rhys has been through so much and it has all been for the better of his people. And so like, I'm not confused why people are like, oh, he's evil, he's secretly evil. Where? When? How? No. I reject that. I can literally talk about Rhys for the entirety of this video. That's how much I love him. He's sarcastic. He's funny. He's loving, protective, like sensitive. Oh my God. And he's beautiful. Not to mention he's literally beautiful. Dark hair, violet eyes, the wings. I mean, Sarah J Maas must have a wing kink, right? Are we gonna talk about that? Rhys is S tier. Rhys is my top guy. He is my husband of all husbands. Like, it does not get higher than Rhys for me. So S tier, no doubt. Okay, next we have Tarquin. Now, Tarquin is the High Lord of the Summer Court. And he is a flirt. He's so sweet. I don't think I have anything bad to say about Tarquin. We don't know a ton about him, so that makes me like hesitate to put him in A tier, because I think A tier should maybe be reserved for the people we know more about and are more connected to. For now, I'm gonna put him in B, but he might move up to A. We'll see. Okay, next we have Varian. He is the Prince of Adriata in the Summer Court, and he's like Amryn's boo. Okay, they're kind of, you know, canoodling a bit, if you will. Seems like a chill guy. Again, we don't know that much about him. In fact, we know more about Tarquin, I would say, than we do about Varian. I'm like fine with him. He seems, you know, he seems chill, but like, yeah, I'm not connected to him. So we're gonna go see. Okay, next we have Helion. He is the High Lord of the Day Court. He is also Lucien's real father. He's a bi king. He's a friend of the Night Court. I like Helion. He's fun. Again, don't know that much about him, but like, cool guy. I think we're gonna put him in C or B. C or B. I think he can go in B. Hey, why not? He seems like a chill guy. No, I don't know that much about him. He's going C. We're pals, but we're not like besties, you know what I mean? Okay, Callias, the High Lord of the Winter Court. Don't really know that much about him. C. I don't know much about him. Seems fine, seems chill. He was on our side in the war, but I don't know much about him. So, C. Oh, and also, I'm sorry if any of my pronunciations are wrong for any names or anything. I'm just pronouncing them how I pronounce them in my head, so. Although I will not apologize for pronouncing Rhys as Rhys, because it's literally Rhysand. Like, that's confirmed. It's Rhysand, not Rhysand, not Rhys. It's Rhys. Okay, Thesson or Thason. Thesson, he's the High Lord of the Dawn Court. Again, don't know much about him. He's chill, I guess, so I'm just gonna put him in C. Okay, King of Highburn, that's a pretty easy one. He's definitely going in F. We don't like that guy. Hey, we do not like that guy. He's caused nothing but trouble. Get him out of here. Okay, Aerys. This is another complicated one. He's from the Autumn Court. Now, you know, when we first get introduced to him, he seems like a bad guy. He's got a bad history with Moore. He's got a bad history with Cassian, a bad history with Asriel too, I think. Like, he's just got a bad history with people all around, bad history with Lucien. But then the more we learn about him, the more it seems like he's just doing all of these things to protect people, but he's also seeming kind of power hungry, so I don't know. But it seems like, you know, he's gonna be a potential friend in the future, somebody we like. He's already an ally, he's already working with the Inner Circle, and he's kind of fun. I can't lie, in A Court of Silver Flames, I was kind of having a fun time with him. I wanna put him in B. Is that bad? Is that bad? Ooh, okay, he's gonna go B for now. I don't know. Oh, this is tough. Okay, next we have Cassian, another bat boy. I love Cassian so much. He is like, you know, the rowdy one, the funny one. I love his relationship with Nesta. I loved getting to learn more about him in A Court of Silver Flames. Like, he could go S, but the thing is, I'm really reserving S for the guys that are like, for me. I think Cass is just more, he's like my friend. He's not really like my husband. I don't know. I think I'm gonna put him in A. I think I'm gonna put him in A, but I totally recognize that for like somebody else, he would be S. But I'm just going for this based off of me. Obviously, I love Cass. Okay, this goes back to the whole A and S are basically at the same level. It's just that S is like kind of like the VIP section for me specifically. And everybody else has their own personal VIP section, okay? And last but not least for the ACOTAR section, we have Lucien. Lucien? Lucien? I feel bad for the guy. I do. I feel like he can't catch a break. He's been dealt a bad hand in life, that's for sure. I like him for the most part. He's obviously made mistakes. I hate, you know, that he's been friends with Tampon. That's unfortunate. But at the end of the day, he's trying his best, and I really hope, you know, we get to see him find his happy ending. Whether that's with Elaine or not, we'll see. That being said, Lucien isn't like my type or anything. I'm not like very attracted to him, but like we're pals, we're buddies, we're friends. I don't know. B tier, I guess? Yeah, if we're putting Eris in B, we have to put Lucien in B. Right? This is my final ranking for all the ACOTAR characters. I'm feeling pretty good about it. But now we're gonna move on to Throne of Glass. We're starting with Lorcan, Lord Lorcan Lachlan, if you will. I love Lorcan so much. Sorry. I know he can kind of be a dick sometimes, but I love him. I was so invested in his story with Aleed. It was so good. And Sarah, we need to know, what did Lorcan do? Okay, he did what? I would love for more Lorcan in Aleed. I just think he's so fun. He's so grumpy all the time. It's hilarious. I'm sorry I'm putting him in A tier. Sorry. I love him. I love him. Also, this is a horrible, horrible picture of him. That is not how I pictured him at all. Okay, next we have Adian. I really enjoyed his story with Lysandra. Up until Kingdom of Ash, when he was being a little asshole, he really pissed me off. I can't even lie. I don't know if it's because, you know, so much of the story was focused on Aelin that I get this vibe from Adian that I just get such brotherly vibes from him, not so much romantic vibes from him. And there were just a lot of times where he pissed me off, to be completely honest. And for that reason, I'm going to put him in B tier. He's not my guy, you know what I mean? He's more like my pal. He's my friend, brotherly vibes. Yeah, so that's why I have Adian in B tier. And then next we have Adian's father, Gavriel, RIP King. That was just the most depressing storyline that they never really got to reconnect. Just, you know, one of the many hardships of Kingdom of Ash. I didn't feel like too much of a romantic connection with him, you know? We weren't that close. Yeah, so I'm gonna go C tier for Gavriel. Next we have Arabin. I hate this man. I hate this man so much. What can I say? Not only did he kill one of my favorite characters in the entire series, he also just was horrible to Aelin, like absolutely horrible, and to Lysandra. And I hate him. I hate him. I hate him so much. He is F. He is F, 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 F. Horrible, horrible man. I hate that man. Okay. Next we have Sam Cortland. What to say? I never expected for a character that is only featured in one book, mind you, one book that is made up of a few short stories, for him to capture my heart in such a deep way. I just never expected it. I really didn't. And I read Throne of Glass, and this is what I think is the superior reading order. I read it Throne of Glass, Crown of Midnight, Assassin's Blade, Air of Fire, so on and so forth. So I knew going into that book what his fate was. And to me, I think that is what made it so much more heart-wrenching, is I spent the entire book falling in love with him, falling in love with his connection to Aelin, or at the time, Selena. And I knew it was gonna get ripped away. And it just broke my heart. But it couldn't stop me from falling in love with him. Like, truly, he is my guy. He is my guy. He was taken from me too soon. And literally any mention of him in the books got me to fucking sob. The fact that he is the one that gave Aelin the mantra of, my name is Sam Cortland and I will not be afraid. That reveal tore my heart out. Oh my God, it makes me sick. Makes me sick. Sam is S tier. That might be crazy, but Sam is like my guy.
He is Reese level. I'm sorry, he is. If he had stuck around for the rest of the series, like, I know I just would have fallen more and more in love with him. Like, I don't know, he's just perfect. He was witty, he was strong.
I loved, he had this secret crush on Selena, but he was so protective. Not a damn day goes by that I don't think about Sam Cortland. So he's S tier. And that's what he deserves, okay? That's what he deserves. Next we have Kale. Now Kale is a part of our original love triangle trio. He is the captain of the guard. Me and Kale had our ups and downs. One second I love Kale, I'm having a great time with Kale. The next second I want to punch him in the face. And for that reason, I could never really fall for Kale in the way that I know some people have. He just pissed me off too much. That being said, once I got to Tower of Dawn, I loved his story with Irene. I thought it was really powerful, really good stuff. But Kale and I, we just have too much beef. So he's gonna go in B tier.
There's a part of the story from like Crown of Midnight to Queen of Shadows that he was in a solid C, if not D. That's how much he was pissing me off.
Because nothing makes me more mad than people coming for Aelin. Okay, I am the number one Aelin supporter. I don't care. If she was on this tier list, she would be above S. That is how much I love Aelin. So if you cross my girl, you're gonna piss me off. Next we have Fenris. He, you know, starts off a little bit, there's a bit of tension there with him, right? He's kind of being a bit of a dick sometimes, but for the most part, he's on our side. And then we get to Kingdom of Ash, and my heart is shattered. My heart is shattered. The relationship and the bond that him and Aelin form, it's just too beautiful for words, truly. I think he has to go A. I hope he, you know, gets some sort of happy ending because he has been through too much. Next we have his brother, Connell. Now I know he was, you know, kind of abused, put through a lot, but he still pissed me off. And we also don't know that much about him. But yeah, towards the end there, oh God, the things he was saying to Fenris really pissed me off. Like, so much. I kind of want to put him in D. Is that bad? Like, he just really made me angry. And I know that might not be justified, but he just really pissed me off. So I'm gonna put him in D. Okay, next we have my man's Rowan. Oh, when I tell you, when I got to Air of Fire, and I had just finished Assassin's Blade, so I had been through a lot of emotional turmoil, getting to meet Rowan was just beautiful. I said, this is what I've been waiting for. My 500-year-old Fae prince. And it was beautiful. Oh my God, the enemies to lovers of it all. The friendship he forms with Aelin and then becoming romantic. Like, it's just beautiful. And he's like the gentle giant, you know? He has this hard exterior, but he's just an ooey gooey guy on the inside. I just love him. Yeah, I think, like, what else is there to say? He's S. I'm sorry, he's S. He just is. I love him. if there was like a tier in between S and A, he might be there. Because for me, Sam and Reese are, they're like my type. But Rowan, he deserves S. He does. He deserves S. Next we have Erwan. When I read it, I pronounced it as Erwan, like the grocery store. I just can't get that out of my head. Obviously he's F, just the absolute scum of the earth. He caused so much havoc for our characters. I can't even get into it, to be honest. Like that final battle, the 13, I actually can't talk about it, I'll start crying. Okay, Sartak? He's a cool guy. We don't know, a ton about him. We get to know him in Tower of Dawn with his relationship with Nezrin, and I really enjoyed it. I thought he was really fun. I like how cocky he was and how honest. He was like so brutally honest and was really nice. I don't know that he's necessarily my type, but like he's chill. He's one of our guys, you know? So I'm gonna put him in B tier. But I can see why some people like are really attached to him. I'd like to know more. I'd like to see more of him and Nezrin. They're a fun couple. And last, but certainly not least, we have Dorian, our princeling. Dorian goes through such a journey in these books. It's actually insane. First book with the whole love triangle thing, I was definitely Team Dorian. I was all about it. I was having so much fun with it. Even in Crown of Midnight, honestly, like I was like, maybe she should go back to Dorian. But then as the series went on, it was so clear. They just had such a beautiful friendship that I just loved. I loved that he was never afraid of her, any parts of her. He accepted her for who she was. I just loved it. And then I loved the development of him and Manon. I pronounce it Manon, but I think it's Manon. I loved it so much. Princeling, witchling. Oh my God, it was so good. Oh my God. And he just gives you the butterflies in the stomach, doesn't he? I don't know whether to put him in A or S. Cause to me, I think he's on the same level as Cassian and Azriel from ACOTAR. I don't know if he's quite reached S. I think what would really push it over the edge is if Sarah J Maas would release a book about Dorian and Manon. Is that too much to ask for? Oh, but it's tough. He really is like the other, you know, the other side of the coin with Reese, which makes me want to put him in S. I just think he might be A, but like the top of A, you know? I know for a lot of people he is S, he's like their guy, but I think I'm gonna put him in A. I'm trying to keep S very, very exclusive. So that is our ranking for Throne of Glass as well as ACOTAR. Now we will be moving into Crescent City, and we are going to be starting with Tristan Flynn. This really tripped me up when I first found this tier list, because I was like, who the fuck is Tristan? And then I was like, oh yeah, Tristan Flynn, because I swear, like, we only call him Flynn for the most part. I really like him. I think he's a lot of fun. I wish we got to see more of him or hear more from him. Seemed like he had some tension with that dragon girl in the last book, or is that the second? I can never freaking remember. But at this point, we just don't know a ton about him. So I'm gonna put him in B tier. Then we have Declan. He is, you know, the other part of that really trio for the most part of Flynn, Deck, and Rune. And he's our little tech whiz. He actually comes in handy like numerous times. He saves their asses with his tech stuff, so we really appreciate him for that. Again, just don't know a ton about him. I would say he's, you know, not my type necessarily. I'm gonna put him in B as well. Yeah, that feels right. And rounding off that little trio, we have Rune. Now I know Rune is a fan favorite, okay? So don't come for my throat here, but he did piss me off a few times. I did really enjoy his story with Lydia. She, in the third book, became genuinely like my favorite character of that entire book. So I did really like their relationship, although I could have had it go on longer personally. I'm just not sure Rune is really my type. Again, I don't know if it's because we're, again, you know, this is Bryce's story, that for Rune, he's feeling more brotherly to me. I think he's gonna go B for me as well. And I know that's like very controversial, because I'm pretty sure he's like S for a lot of people. And don't get me wrong, I love him. But this is my personal ranking for my men, for me. Next, we have the freaking Autumn King. What's with Autumn Kings and just being the worst? It's Bryce's dad, Rune's dad, and he is just the scum of the earth. There's a few times where you think, oh, maybe, you know, he's gonna have a little bit of a redemption. He's gonna become a better person. No, he's not. And he doesn't. He fails at that at every turn. So he's F for sure. F. We don't like him. Okay, next we have our wolf boys. So starting with Ethan. This is tough because in the second book, I was really feeling Ethan for a bit there. Our sunball player. They never shut up about him playing sunball. I'd love to know like how sunball works. What are the rules, you know? But yeah, I was feeling him for a bit. I was like, he's fun, actually. I like him. I like his motivations. He's really sweet. I liked, you know, his secret crush on Bryce. But then, I don't know, in the third one, like his character just went off the rails a little bit. He just got a little bit too reckless, making so many mistakes. Like, it was just like, what are we doing here, Ethan? Come on, dude. I'm like, why am I wanting to put like all the Crescent City people in B? Just made me kinda angry. He's just like a little whiny, isn't he? This is tough. I might put him in C, to be honest. Like he needs a little bit of a timeout in C after the third book. He'll redeem himself if there's a fourth. But then we have his brother Connor. And Connor, we only know him for a short amount of time in the first book. RIP. He got a little bit of the Sam Cortland treatment. But from the time that we had with him, I was really digging him. I was like, he's really fun. For a first love interest, like I'm really enjoying myself. But we don't know him that well. So he can go and see with his brother. Okay, next we have Cormac. He's a fey prince. Thought we were gonna have a little bit of an arranged marriage storyline going on. Got cut off kind of quickly. Crescent City, you know, here's a little side tangent. I loved the first book, adored the first book. I thought it was perfect. It was, I mean, I cried a couple times. Like, it was the most invested I felt, I think, you know, with one of the first books in a series for Sarah J Maas. The Zootopia of it all was really entertaining. But the second and third books lost me a bit. And so Cormac, I think there was a lot of potential with his character, but we just didn't really get there with him, unfortunately. I'm gonna put him in C. The time we did have, I thought he was really fun. I felt very bad with him and, what was it, Sophia? They're, you know, it was just tragic. But yeah, he's going C. Okay, next we have Pullux. I hate this man. I hate him so much for what he has done to Lydia. Like I said, Lydia's like my new favorite character in the Crescent City books. So I hate him. I hate him so much. F for sure. He's the scum of the earth. Okay, next we have Hunt. And this is tough. Book one, I would say Hunt. I was all for Hunt. I was having a great time with Hunt. You know, despite some of his mistakes, I just found him really compelling. But at the end of the day, like, he's kind of boring. I don't know. He just doesn't have that certain je ne sais quoi for me. He is A. Like, let's give it to him. He is A. It's just towards the end, he was just kind of like making me upset a little bit, but he is A. Okay, next we have Isaiah. You know, we don't know Isaiah too well, but from what we've seen of him, I really like him. He's a really good friend to all of our characters. He has this like sense of duty with him and responsibility. Yeah, he's a good guy. He's a good guy. I think he's gonna go C. Next we have Regulus. He's an Asteri. They are just little parasite assholes, aren't they? And he's an asshole. He's an F. He's an F. Micah is the archangel. And he is also an asshole. I thought maybe, you know, throughout the beginning of that first book, I thought maybe he could become an ally. No. He's an asshole. He's in the F tier. And the F tier is getting full. There's a lot of assholes in the Sarah J Maas universe. Okay, next we have Therian. Therian, I feel similarly to Therian as I do to like Kale from Throne of Glass. Therian just pisses me off. He's just such a self-sabotager. It's just so frustrating. Dude, we're so close. Why do you keep doing this shit? It's so annoying. And it's like sometimes he's charming and then other times he's just being a dick. You know, if we get another book, I think there could be something really fun brewing with him and, oh, what is her name? She is Tristan Flynn's sister. I'm blanking on her name, but I liked the tension starting to build there between them two. He's a merman, that's fun. But he just pisses me off too much. He has to go see. I'm sorry. Okay, next we have our Prince of Hell, Adis. I thought he was maybe gonna play a bigger role than he did. I even thought, oh, is this gonna be like a love triangle situation with Hunt and Adis? But yeah, so I thought he was gonna play a bigger role and I was kind of excited for that, but he didn't really. But he was very charming and I liked that he can turn into a cat. That's fun. He's gonna go see. And last but not least, we have Baxian. Baxian is somebody we think is a bad guy. Then we find out, no, he's actually a good guy. He was Danica's freaking mate, which is so, just so tragic and heartbreaking. And I actually really liked him. Similar to Lydia becoming one of my favorite characters in the third book, Baxian quickly became one of my favorite characters. I just really enjoyed any time he was at the forefront. I liked his sarcasm. I liked that he had this like hard exterior that was starting to break down and he's starting to make friends, and like he just wanted friends. And he was having such a tough time making friends because everybody thought he was an asshole. Yeah, I actually just really, I really enjoyed him. So I'm gonna put him in A. Is it bad I wanna put him in A above like Rune? Sorry, it's my tier list. I can put him wherever I want. I really liked Baxian. He was just for me. So that is my completed tier list. Hold on, let me try and sort this with everybody in here in order, maybe. All right, there. I think that's somewhat in order within the tiers. It's kind of hard to decide for some of them, but that is my completed tier list. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you made it all the way to the end, congrats. I know it was probably a long one. I just needed to get some of these thoughts out of my head. I am obviously so obsessed with all of these books and with Sarah J Maas. I will definitely be reading anything that she puts out into the world. I mean, I literally also have one of the coloring books as well. Like, it is genuinely all I think about. So if you guys enjoyed this video and you want me to do, you know, more like this in the future, let me know. I know it's been a really long time since I've done a tier list video, but I just felt like this was the perfect outlet to talk about these books in some way. All of my socials will be linked down in the description, as well as a link to this tier list if you want to do it yourself. I also have a link to my Spotify, and on my Spotify, I have a Sarah J Maas playlist called A Better World if you want to check that out. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Leave a like, comment down below, and I will see you next time. Bye! Will she ever shut up about Sarah J Maas? Probably not.